And welcome to this tutorial on how to create clothes materials. My name is Joel Palmius, and I am the community manager of the Make Human community. In this video, I will go through the basic steps for creating materials for your clothes. Most of this is not specific for MPFB. It is common for how you will go about creating any image-based material. However, bringing it all together might not be an entirely obvious process. Most of the video is hands-on, and I will not spend any particular effort on the background theory. There is a four-part series on MPFB materials available in the YouTube channel. I would encourage you to watch these videos before continuing here, so that you have an understanding of how materials work. Or you could simply continue here and see the basic steps for how to construct a clothes material from scratch. Anyway, so we have a basic piece of clothes. Here, I have created a basic t-shirt by extracting the helper tights helpers, after which I deleted the superfluous vertices. Nothing else has been done with the mesh so far. Now we need to decide what it is we want. Primarily, we need to decide if we want to get fancy with details, or if there is a part of the clothes we want to have higher detail in. The level of detail will be important for UV unwrapping later on. We will also need to think through what we want to control with the material. Are we satisfied with only influencing color with an image texture, or do we want to vary roughness or maybe have a normal map? For now, for the first basic material, I'm deciding that there's no need to have different levels of detail in different parts of the clothes. I'm also satisfied with only controlling the color. My goal here will be to create a simple blue t-shirt with a smiley face on it. Now, the obvious next step here would be to start stacking on colors and painting and so forth. However, there is a step missing. First, let's select all vertices in edit mode. This looks like you would expect a mesh to look. However, now let's take a look in the UV editing panel. This won't do at all. Here we can see that all faces have been squeezed together. This will be difficult to paint. Back in the layout panel, we will add seams. I find it helpful to think of the UV unwrapping as cutting out pieces for the clothes from a fabric. The seams are where you would sew this together. Let's add seams where you would normally expect to find these on a t-shirt. You can see that red lines are added, indicating that this is where the mesh will be cut when UV unwrapping. Now we can UV unwrap. In the UV editing panel, we can see that this looks decent already. If we want, we can move the islands around to allow them to get more space. Now we have a mesh which is ready for texture painting. If there is a material here, simply delete it. Next, we go to the Make Skin panel. This doesn't look as expected. There's no Create Material panel here. What has happened is that we've been bitten by a Blender bug. Sometimes it refuses to delete an empty material. No worries, we just create a new material and then delete it. Now we have a Create Material panel. Here it is important that you think through what kind of textures you want. It is possible to change the setup later, but it is cumbersome, so spend a few seconds planning ahead. Now, I've already decided that I just want a simple color setup for texture painting, so I'm satisfied with the diffuse texture. A 2K by 2K resolution is plenty enough. For most situations, you would want to generate the images too. Now we're ready for texture painting. In order to see what we're doing, we need to switch to material preview mode. Let's start by painting a blue line to demonstrate the consequences of the UVs. Here you can see that the line does not connect. In the other direction, if we paint on the mesh, we see that the line does not connect on the UV. This is why you want to plan ahead for the UV stuff. If you want an intricate pattern somewhere, then having a seam in the middle of it will likely cause problems for you. Anyway, let's paint the shirt blue. Now we can add a smiley face. There. Maybe not the most beautiful thing I ever painted, but good enough for demonstration. Now let's go and adjust some of the basic properties of the material. The most important value here will be the roughness value. For cotton cloth, a roughness value of 0.7 is usually decent. Feel free to play around with the other properties too. You could, for example, have a metallic shirt if you want to. Now let's produce the clothes and load them on a character. There, not overly complicated. Now, let's step this up a bit. For my next project, I intend to create a button-down shirt with a semblance of cloth wrinkles. Further, I want the buttons to be smooth and metallic, while I want the rest of the clothes to have a cotton-like roughness. In reality, you would most likely want to edit the mesh first. Maybe you would like the neckline to look different, with a collar or something. But since this video is about materials, I'll make do with this simple mesh. First, we want to fix the UVs. Same procedure as last time. Now we're ready to add materials. As stated, I want clothes wrinkles and buttons. This leads me to conclude I want a normal map. Further, the buttons and the rest of the shirt should have different colors, so we need a diffuse texture. The buttons and the cloth has different roughness, so I want a roughness texture. And finally, I want the buttons to be metallic, while the shirt should be cloth, so I want a metallic map. This time, I'll opt for higher resolution. I'll start with a normal map. For this, I'll use a multi-resolution modifier. Using this, you can sculpt detail without actually modifying the mesh. For a low-resolution mesh such as this, you can add a bunch of subdivisions. However, clothes wrinkles will look more believable if you start at a low level of subdivision. The upside of multi-resolution modifier is that you can vary between levels freely. Now we're ready for sculpting. The most important setting here is to make very sure you are not using Dyntopo. If you enable this, you might ruin the UVs. If you feel the need for a higher resolution, it's better to increase the subdivisions of the multi-resolution modifier. Apart from this, you can use most of the sculpt tools. Now, sculpting isn't my area of expertise. I'm a happy amateur at best, but I'll make a spirited attempt to at least demonstrate the principles. I'll start with adding some wrinkles. I'll simply use the cloth drag brush and move around some areas of the shirt. You will most likely need to experiment a bit with this to get it to look good. Next, I'll simulate overlapping cloth where the buttons should be. I'll tweak this a bit. Most of this is because I'm unused to sculpting, rather than having some master plan. Now we'll add buttons. For this, I'll want a bit more detail. Okay, not beautiful, but good enough. Now comes the trick for turning this into a normal map. You decrease the level of subdivisions to zero here. What we will make is the difference between the viewport display and the rendered version. If you forget to turn this down to zero, you'll get a completely flat normal map. Next, we go to the shader tab to select which image we want to put the output in. Make sure this is the only node which is selected. Now we go to the bake panel. Check bake from multi-res and select normals for output. And we click bake. Now let's take a look in the texture paint tab. We can see that we got a credible normal map. Since we're satisfied with this, we can remove the multi-res modifier. This will also remove the sculpt, so don't do this until you're finished sculpting. As you can see, the mesh is all shiny. This is because we're using a roughness map and it is all black. This is equal to a roughness value of 0. Let's fix this first by using a light gray, which is equal to a roughness value of about 0.8. Next, we'll paint the shirt with a wine red something color. Now for the buttons. It doesn't matter much in which order you do the texture here, but depending on color, it might be difficult to see what you paint. Let's do it in the order roughness, metallicness, and color. So we start by painting different roughness value for the buttons. Next, we do the metallicness. Here, white is completely metal. Finally, we'll do the color of the buttons. Obviously, you could have taken one of the image texture and used it as a template in GIMP or something and simply fill with the appropriate color. But I'm opting to do it the old Blender way here. Let's take a look at this in rendered view. Looks decent. Let's render too. There. In reality, you would probably spend a lot more effort on both sculpting and the painting than what I did here. And someone who's an actual artist would probably also get it to look good. Obviously, there's a whole lot more you can do. For example, you can have transparent parts or even parts that emit light. Some of this is covered in the general series on materials. But this concludes today's tutorial. Thank you for watching and happy modeling.